guys. This is the almighty D, no pun intended. Who knows if that even makes sense anymore? I don't even know. I just thought of it on the top of my head one day, and I'm just going to stick with it because I'm an idiot. So, I was watching Industrial Gamer's video, and he's talking about negativity. And as I was watching, I didn't watch the whole thing yet. Sorry. I will, though. Don't worry if you're watching this. And he's talking about negativity. I thought to myself, damn, he's right. A lot of games are negative. I am negative myself, I would not lie. Most of the time I am negative. And, well, I was thinking a new series to come up with, and this just came out of nowhere. I don't know what I'm going to call the series yet, but I'm going to look back at old games, and I'm going to talk about how much I enjoyed them. And sorry, I'm looking at the mirror in back of me, which is you can't see, obviously, because and I'm back of the camera. So, yeah, if I'm not looking at the camera, my bad. I'm still not used to it. I don't know why. But, yeah, he's talking about negativity and how people enjoy games. I'm like, damn, yo. He's right. Dang. Most of my videos, pretty negative. Well, people actually commenting on my stuff. They're like, well, I'm subscribed. And I'm like, bitch, I don't give a shit. Which I really don't, to be honest, because I do what I do and I like what I do. So, sometimes I'm in like a hyper mood, sometimes I'm in a mood where I'm like just explaining stuff, sometimes I'm just in a dull mood and I feel like I don't do a video well, and I still upload, which is kind of bad, but let's just get to the point of the video. He kind of inspired me. I already did Indie Outlook, which I kind of want to try to do every other week or so. I'm thinking of series, and I just, you know, fuck that nigga, I think. Maybe I'm crazy. If you seen the bug, if not, if I didn't kill that shit, then I'm fucked, because I don't like bugs. I already killed plenty. But now I'm just drifting off so much. But yeah, I want to do a wrestling series. I want to do a retro series. I want to do an indie series. I just want to do a other series, you know, and then I'll do unboxings and all that jazz, because I want to bring, like, certain content. And I feel like I never really brought that type. So I'm going to start off with my first game, and I have a lot of memories of this game, and it is probably one of my most memorable games. I want to say it's my favorite game. In fact, it's probably, it doesn't rank that high up in the list of games. I mean, nostalgia would rank up high, but gameplay-wise, and yeah. Yeah, so the game is Super Mario Sunshine. Now, I'm a huge Nintendo fan. I don't know if you can see stuff up there. I have Nintendo stuff, I have 3DS stuff, I got a fucking Mario up there, Bowser, got a fucking bag over there somewhere. I'm pretty sure it's somewhere in the still shot. And I go to Nintendo World, I like it. It's not, I was kind of disappointed with the store, I'm not going to lie, again, negative. but yeah. I remember this game was coming out. My brother got a GameCube with Super Smash Bros. Melee. I think it launched with that. I may be wrong, maybe right. And then they showed this game, and it was on the commercial a lot. I don't remember when it came out. It was probably 2001, 2002. I think it's 2002. It was probably, damn, you know, I was like 12 years ago. That was when I was 8. And, yeah, I kept seeing commercials in the summer, and it actually came out, too. And I just, you know, back then when you're a kid, your parents, I mean, some are spoiled today. Mine kind of got me a game every so once in a while, so I had to wait till my birthday to get this game. I think it came out probably August or July. And I would go to Kmart, and I would see it on the demo. I'm like, damn, I really want this game. I kept telling him, like, remember, it's my birthday. Get me this game, it's my birthday. And I'm like, damn, y'all really want this game. And, like, I would go to Kmart, and I would try to get the kids out of the way. I'm like, come on, I want to play the game, man. It was always that first, I think it was the, it was something Hills. Bianca Hills is the first area. And it was just that stage. And I was like, this game is huge, man. And it wasn't that huge of a level. But back then, it was kind of like, whoa, dude, it's an open world and everything. And I was like, damn, yo, Mario's doing tricks he never did before. Yo, he has a water dude. And I'm like, I want this game. And I was a huge fan of 64. I got a lot of the stars. And when I got this game on my birthday, I remember it like it was yesterday. My parents pulled this trick. And I come home from school. And I'm like, looking at my presents, and I see a shoebox, like two shoeboxes. And I'm like, I asked for no shoes, man. So they hand me one of the shoeboxes. I open it up. It's actually a pair of shoes. I'm like, fucking shoes. What am I going to do with those? And then I open all the shoeboxes. It has a random assortment. It has a Super Mario Sunshine in there. Some random toy I wanted. I don't remember what else because this was a highlight of my birthday. I was like, oh my god, yo, I finally have it. I finally play. And I was hogging my brother's GameCube. I remember it. And it was really like disappointing. To like, you know, think you don't have a gift, especially when you're like 8. And I'm like, damn, yo, how they treat a kid like that? Like, damn, yo. Till today, I still don't understand. I never mentioned this to them, but I'm like, those assholes. Tricked. But I get the game, and I just... Back then, I was able to play a game back to back. I would do the same missions over and over because I enjoyed the game. Nowadays, not really. I mean, Super Mario Galaxy... I probably could go back to, and, you know, I'll play it a lot, so, I played this a lot, Super Mario Sunshine, and, like, I didn't beat the game until I was maybe, damn, had to be 12 to 14, because I remember that I just couldn't beat this one part. It was a Yoshi stage. And I think it was in Rico Harbor, which is like this area. And you have to shoot these fish, and they turn into platforms that disappear after a while if you take too long. I was just never good at it. Once you land in the water as Yoshi, he disintegrates. You got to get another Yoshi from the pipe by kicking the fruit. And if I remember correctly, you needed to do that mission to get Shadow Mario. And to face the final Bowser, you had to face every Shadow Mario in the game, I think. This might actually have been after it, but I remember there was a few stages that I couldn't beat. There was the mansion stages, which were pretty hard. Pretty sure nowadays they're probably doing like one shot. And then you had the secret stuff. But I got around a good, like, so many stars. And then, like, I remember it like it was... Man, I just remember like the manta ray stage especially, where you had to destroy the giant manta ray. That was like the hardest shit in the world because the controls were just... It was so random. I was like, what the hell do I do? It was like you aim it at it and the manta ray's on the ground. He's shocking you and shit. And I remember there was one trick. You jump on the umbrella. And I'm pretty sure he couldn't have got you up there. Then after that, there was another one. Clean the beach in like 2 minutes. I'm like, yo, how the hell am I supposed to do this? It was like goo all over the beach. I'm like, as a kid, you're not that good at games. Maybe you are. I don't know. Not when you're like 8. But I clearly remember that I had to get my brother's help for one of those stages. I don't think he could even do it. Like, I think it was the point where I had to do it. Because I remember he never even beat that game. And I honestly played his GameCube more than he did. He played his PlayStation 2 more because he had, like, stuff like SOCOM, I think. Though that was probably not out at the time. But I know he played all this stuff, like Grand Theft Auto. And it was just so fun. The platforming, the music. I remember the commercial. He's like, I'm the tropical island.
On a tropical island. Mario is taking a well-deserved vacation.
Like, I want this. And that was when I was waiting for my like birthday. I'm like, damn, my parents are getting me. And I'm like, when am I going to get it? I'm back to that story. And it was just, the music was great. The level design was great. Back then, I thought the voice acting was cool for Bowser. But now that I think about it, it's kind of cheesy. Should never do that again. Just have Bowser growl.
The water's great, hey, Junior?
Sure is, Papa!
Maybe a Mario voice act. I don't know if I'd go that far. The simplicity in Mario I enjoy. The story was just dumb. Peach goes on a vacation with Mario, and then they find out this, and then it shines sprays instead of stars, which is like the first thing that was different about it. Pretty much the same. I mean, shine sprays just have like extra points to them, which I think it's like an octagon shape if you flatten them out. And I just remember that, you know, the game had those really tough stages where you had to go in the toy box room and you're going on rolling blocks and cubes sliding around and stage flipping. And I was like, yo, this game is hard. Like, that game today, I think, is still hard. Like, if I played it now, I honestly think I would get my ass handed to me. I'm not even gonna lie. Alright, sorry guys. So, my bad, I was checking the camera. I had to delete stuff to make space because I only have a few minutes. But Yeah, once I became like a teenager and I started playing it again, it was something else. The game is just so much fun. Like I don't know how to describe it. Like it was different. Like no Mario games today still plays like it. Though I would say Galaxy is better overall as a package, and I would think the gameplay is like better too. But it was different. You've never seen a game like that again. I remember Mutant Muds, the 2D game, had a trailer for the 3D version, and it kind of looked like it. I was like, damn, you know, that'd be pretty cool if they made one. And, they never made something similar. So, you know, once I was a kid and I made it to the final stage, again, that was a hell of a ride, because that volcano stage was like a trial of hell. You had to jump on spikes across this thing in the lobby, land in the lobby, you died. Lava was a one-hit kill in that game. I don't think you bounced up like 64. If you did, well, it was on these small platforms anyway, and you're pretty much getting your ass whipped. And then you get onto a boat, and you had to, because they had the boat stages, and you had to spray in back of it, and it would move. And back then, like, I didn't understand like physics. If you shoot left on the back of the boat, it would go right. So it was weird. I don't know if that's like physics related, but I remember that part was tough. Then you get the rocket jumps, you jump into the clouds, and then you finally get to the Bowser Lair, and he was in the bathtub. I'm like, what the? Like, I was so disappointed. I knew the stage because I had the strategy guide, but I was like, when I seen it myself, they even had a cutscene. I'm like, what the hell is this? Like, I played this whole game for that. It was a different type of boss battle, don't get me wrong, but it was kind of disappointing of a boss battle. It's still fun, don't get me wrong. I felt accomplished as fuck. And then, again, I stopped playing after I beat it. I was like, I'll beat it. And then I went back to it, and I wanted to get all the stars. So I tried to get all the stars. They had the blue coins scattered across the stage. And I'm like, yo, these coins, yo, I'm going to get them all. So I get them all, and I have 119 stars. So there's 120 in that game. And there was this one fucking blue coin. Every time I would collect it, guess what would happen? My game would freeze. I had the original launch copy of the game, and some of them will freeze. And it was just so disappointing to find out I could never 100% it. So I had to borrow my friend's player's choice copy. Played it for a day, got that fucking coin. And finally accomplished the game. And back then, when you beat a game, especially since you didn't get many, you felt accomplished. And back then I wasn't that good either. So I played the hell out of it. And I wasn't that good. So I would play it all day. I would play the same stages. It was just like, damn, this game is fun. Nowadays, more of a negative opinion. I don't know why. I can't play a game like more than once most of the time. Last of Us, I probably could play again when that comes out. Super Mario Galaxy, I could play that all day, every day. I probably would play it every day. It's like classic games. I can't play new games. Like, I won't play Call of Duty Ghost Campaign again, ever, unless I'm trying to get a trophy. It's just like, it's not fun. Like, I don't know. Like, I probably played Kid Icarus again. That game had a lot of shit to unlock, but, like, it's like, once I beat it now, it's, I mean, they're fun, don't get me wrong. There's some games I will definitely go back to eventually, but now, not so much. So, that's my look back at Super Mario Sunshine. If you played this game, let me know what you think. I also thought this cover was pretty fucking sweet at the time. I don't know why. Now I'm looking at it, and because I went to college for like art, it's pretty fucking basic, but simplicity does do justice sometimes. So I guess it did justice. Back then I thought this was a cool cover, and that's all I really have to say. So let me know what you think if you played this game. Let me know what you think about my story about this game. It's not even me really talking about gameplay, it was more of me talking about me getting the game. But again, that was back in the day, so hope you enjoy.